Hi everyone, in this video we will go over the bones and the muscles of the neck. First, let's start with the bones. Right here we have the mandible. This is the lower part of the mandible. This is the mandible that carries the teeth of the lower jaw. What we can see on the model is this part of the mandible. The second bone on the model is the hyoid bone. This is the hyoid bone. It is the only bone in the body that does not articulate with another bone. The hyoid bone is a C shape, and also it provides a site for attachment of the muscles of the neck. The third bone on the model is the clavicle bone. We can see part of the clavicle bone on each side. Let's start with the muscles. First, we have the digastric muscle on each side. This part is the anterior belly of the digastric muscle. That is also the anterior belly of the digastric muscle. We can only see a very small part of the posterior belly, the digastric muscle. Underneath the digastric muscle, we have the mylohyoid muscle. The mylohyoid muscle, it is attached to the mandible and the hyoid bone. The mylohyoid muscle, it looks like an M letter. Moving to the third muscle, which is the stylohyoid muscle. The stylohyoid muscle, it runs between the hyoid bone right here. And it runs between the styloid process of the temporal bone. This is the styloid process of the temporal bone. So on this side also we can see part of the stylohyoid muscle. Moving laterally, we have only part of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. This is also the sternocleidomastoid muscle, which runs between the sternum, the clavicle, and the mastoid process of the temporal bone. This is the mastoid process of the temporal bone. This is the styloid process of the temporal bone. Moving to the muscles right here on both sides, first, this structure is the thyroid cartilage. This muscle, which is in close proximity to the thyroid cartilage, and it runs to the hyoid bone, this is the thyrohyoid muscle. So on this side, we can see the thyrohyoid muscle. Lateral to the thyrohyoid muscle, we have the sternohyoid muscle. The sternohyoid muscle, it runs between the sternum, which is the bone in the thorax, and the hyoid bone. So you can see the sternohyoid muscle. Lateral to it, we can see the omohyoid muscle. So this is the omohyoid muscle. Moving inferiorly, we can see the three scalene muscles. First, we have the anterior scalene muscle. Second, we have the middle scalene muscle. Third is the posterior scalene muscle. So this is the anterior scalene muscle, that is the middle scalene muscle, and this is the posterior scalene muscle. On this model, we can see part of the trapezius muscle right here. Also, we can see part of the levator scapula muscle. Let's repeat the muscles one more time. This is the anterior belly of the digastric muscle. That is the mylohyoid muscle. This is the stylohyoid muscle. This is part of the stylohyoid muscle. This is the sternocleidomastoid muscle. That is part of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. This is the thyroid cartilage. This is the thyrohyoid muscle. The sternohyoid muscle. Omohyoid muscle. Again, thyrohyoid muscle. Sternohyoid muscle. Omohyoid muscle. Right here, we can see the three scalene muscles. This is the anterior scalene muscle, middle scalene muscle, posterior scalene muscle. This is part of the trapezius muscle, and this is the levator scapula muscle.